सस्टिकल स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी सॉल्विंग सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दिस इज अ ट्रायंगल एबीसी, इट्स अ ट्रायंगल एबीसी, राइट एंगल लेट बी, एबी इज 5, एंगल एसीबी दैट इज एंगल सी इज 30 डिग्री। डिटरमिन लेंथ ऑफ साइड बीसी एंड एसी। We want find, the length of BC and AC, this one and this one. So how can we do? So now students, we know the trigonometric ratio. We know trigonometric ratios, anyone you can apply. Maybe you can apply sine 30 degree is equal to opposite sine by hypotenuse. Now opposite side of 30 degree, actually for 30 degree angle, what is the opposite side? Is 5, it's given 5 centimeter divided by hypotenuse is not given, that is AC. Now guys, we already know the value for sine 30 degree. Now I hope you remember what was sine 30 degree. Any student remember what is sine 30 degree? Yes, students, please tell me what is sine 30 degree. We had derived sine 60 degree as, if you remember, in that equilateral triangle, when we found out the perpendicular was under root 3 by 2, so sine 60 was under root 3 by 2. What is sine 30?
1 by 2.
Very good. So 1 by 2 is equal to 5 by AC. From this, students, we will find hypotenuse. AC is equal to 5 into 2, that is 10 centimeter. So this question is done. Then he says find BC. Now in which trigonometric ratio BC and hypotenuse will come? Let's see. So for 30 degree angle, BC is adjacent side. So we know cos of 30 degree is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, and that is equal to BC by hypotenuse. Already we have calculated as 10, right? So cos 30, we know what's the value of cos 30. Cos 30 and sin 60 are complementary. They have same value. Root 3 by 2 is equal to BC by 10. From here, we can find BC is equal to root 3 by 2 into 10, that is equal to 5 under root 3. You can also give the answer in points. You have done both the questions. You have seen, students. Now, you could also do this by tan 30 also. You could also do this by tan 30. Answer would be same. Let's try. Now you see, students, tan 30 is equal to opposite side, that is 5, by base, that is BC. Let's try to find out BC from here. Would be equal to 5 by tan 30. So students, do you remember what is tan 30? Tan 30 will be equal to sine 30 by cos 30. Now what is sine 30? 1 by 2. What is cos 30? Students, under root 3 by 2. So this is equal to 1 by root 3, tan 3. So it's 1 by root 3. So see that this is equal to 5 root 3. It's coming same. So it's not only by sine, whichever is more suitable to you, more convenient to you, you can apply that trigonometric ratio. Good. Students, let's move to second question. It says, find out the value of cos 45 divided by secant 30 plus cosecant 30. So students, do you remember all the values here? What is cos 45? Anybody remembers cos 45? So once again, you see how we found out cos 45. When the angle was 45, both these sides were same. We took both these sides as 1, 1. So hypotenuse will be under root 2. 1 square plus 1 square root. So you see that cos 45 is equal to sine 45 is equal to either adjacent side by hypotenuse or opposite side by hypotenuse. In both the cases, it will be 1 by root 2. So it's 1 by root 2 divided by what is secant 30? Any student? Now, secant 30 is 1 by cos 30. So you need to remember secant 30 plus cosecant 30, that is reciprocal of sine 30. So you know, few diplomatic ratios you can always derive otherwise. So that will be equal to 1 by root 2 divided by, now students, what is sine 30? Anyone remembers?
1 by 2.
So 1 by 1 by 2 will be 2. What is cos 30? Under root 3 by 2.
By 2.
Under root, so it will become 2 by under root 3. Am I right? Am I right, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Cos 30? Tell me again. Under root 3 by 2. So it will be 2 by under root 3, right? So this will be equal to 1 by under root 2 divided by, it will be root 3 here. Here will be 2 plus, here will be, what students, please tell me? 2?
2 under root 3.
Correct, 2 under root 3. So this will be equal to, yes, tell me, now this will go up, am I right? So it's like 1 by under root 2 into under root 3 divided by 2 into 1 plus under root 3. So the answer is, this is equal to under root 3 divided by 2 under root 2 into 1 plus under root 3. His answer. So students, let's do one more sum. He has given sine of a minus b is 1 by 2. Now students, can you tell me if sine of some angle, he is representing that angle in the form of a minus b, is equal to 1 by 2. Now students, tell me sine of which angle is 1 by 2? Sine of which angle is 1 by 2?
30 degree.
That means A minus B should be equal to 30 degree. Then he says the second one, cos of A plus B is 1 by 2. Now student, cos of which angle is 1 by 2?
60 degree.
So cos of 60 is equal to 1 by 2. From this, what do we get? This and this is same. So A plus B is equal to 60. Right? This is my second equation. This is my first equation. If I add both, 2A is equal to 90. So A would be equal to 45. When A is 45, so what will be B? That will be 45 minus 30 would be equal to 15 degree. So students, A is 45 degree and B is 15 degree. He has also given the condition A should be more than B. It's true. Then A plus B should be more than 0. Yes, it's more than 0. It's 60 degree and less than or equal to 90. Both the conditions are satisfied. This is also done. Now students, let's do this sum. It's a triangle, PQR. So this may be, it's right angled at Q. When he says it is right angled at Q, means this angle will be what? This angle will
90
be?
90 degree.
No, naam kya hoga is angle?
Q. Ka?
It will be Q. So it will be PQR. You can also name it PQR, no problem. Now PQ is 3. PQ is 3. PR is 6. This is hypotenuse is 6. Now he says find angle QPR. QPR means this angle. And angle PRQ. PRQ. This angle. Obviously, sum of these two. Once we find this angle, so 90 minus this angle will be this angle, because these two angles are complementary. That means their sum is equal to 90 degrees. Am I right?
90 degrees.
Am I right? So how can we do it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Any student can tell me how can we do it? Basically, in this triangle, let us say this is theta. Let us assume this is theta. Then this is your adjacent side, and this is opposite side. This is your adjacent side, and this is your hypotenuse. Now, do you know any trigonometric ratio which is including opposite side and hypotenuse? Which is a trigonometric ratio in which you get opposite side and hypotenuse, because both are given? So it will be
sine theta
is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. That is 3 by 6 means 1 by 2. Now we know sine theta is 1 by 2. So obviously theta would be equal to, when sine theta is 1 by 2. Anyone? Theta would be equal to sine theta. Sine of some angle is equal to 1 by 2. So then theta is equal to
30 degrees.
If it is given sine of theta is under root 3 by 2, that means theta is 60 degrees. So theta is 30. Obviously, this angle will be 90 minus 30, 60 degrees. Am I right? Or you can find out other way also. If you don't want to find this way, there are so many ways. Like if you say now this is, I can find by this. Let's say I consider this angle as alpha. Let us say this angle as alpha. Now student, can you tell 3 by 6 is what? Any student can tell? Suppose this angle is alpha. Then for alpha angle, what is this 3 side? For alpha angle, this is QR is opposite side and PQ is the
adjacent side.
Adjacent side by hypotenuse is what? Cos. What is this angle?
Alpha.
So cos of alpha is equal to 1 by 2, students. That means alpha would be equal to
60 degrees.
Yes, beautiful. So alpha would be 60 degrees. You can find so many ways. You can solve a question by hundreds of ways. And always try to solve question by different ways. So guys, do you think you got some hands-on training in solving the questions on trigonometric, especially Hamza?
Yes, sir.
All the best, students. You have any doubt? You can always come back to me. Bye.